This might look like a regular Minecraft house, but what if I told you it wasn't? Instead of placing down every block by hand, this house is built using React components. And in this video, I'll show you how I made this possible, why you would do that, and how you can build your very own Minecraft builds using React. React is the most used JavaScript framework for building user interfaces. And although it is most popular for building modern web applications, it can also be used for building other interfaces, like iOS or Android applications. What makes this possible is the separation of React.js and the platform-specific libraries like React DOM for the web and React Native for mobile user interfaces. React.js therefore includes shared logic for state management, rendering, and component management, while React DOM is responsible for actually rendering the interface into your browser, using APIs provided by the browser to manipulate the HTML. DOM stands for Document Object Model and is a way to programmatically access and modify HTML documents, most of the time using JavaScript. While React DOM and React Native are maintained by Meta, who also maintains React.js, there are dozens of community-driven implementations for custom React renderers that use React components to build command-line interfaces, email templates, and even PDFs. In fact, there are so many custom renderers, they even have their own awesome React renderer repository. It looks like if it exists, it already has a React renderer, but we're not quite there yet. One renderer nobody dared to create yet is one that can quite literally change the world. Or at least a world. A Minecraft world. Are you tired of placing block after block after block? Well, do I have good news for you. Now you can play the game without even playing the game. React Minecraft allows you to automate all block placements using technology used and loved by thousands of developers around the world. Minecraft React components are reusable and can contain any logic that you can come up with in JavaScript. So, how does this work? React provides a package called React Reconciler, which, by the way, is not mentioned anywhere in the entire React documentation a single time, and I ended up only finding it after source diving the React core code. But shortly after, I found out that my poor Googling skills weren't the only reason I had such a hard time finding the package and documentation for React Reconciler. Experimental package. Use at your own risk. Does not follow a common versioning scheme. An incomplete reference. But nothing could hold me back anymore. I'm too close to achieving my goal to create the ultimate React renderer. The React Reconciler API allows us to define what should happen inside a host system when React components are rendered. For React DOM, the host system is a DOM. For React Minecraft, it will be a Minecraft world. More specifically, we'll be using a Minecraft server as a host system. While Minecraft servers are usually used to have a world where you can play together with your friends, the main reason I'm using is honestly because it was the easiest way that I could find to modify a Minecraft world in JavaScript. Minecraft servers for the Java edition are usually written in, well, Java and not JavaScript. But thankfully, Flying Squid exists. Flying Squid is an open source project that aims to provide a Minecraft compatible server and a JavaScript API. They achieve that by implementing the Minecraft Server Protocol, which is actually just a reverse engineered documentation that some script kiddies keep up to date, because Mojang to this day never released an official specification. So we can connect to the server that Flying Squid creates with a regular Minecraft client and play like it's a completely normal Minecraft world. Well, almost. While not all features of Minecraft are actually working, as Flying Squid has to implement any server-side Minecraft mechanics by themselves, block placements are actually working, and that's good enough for me. This is the React Minecraft block component. It is used to render one specific block into our Minecraft world. It allows us to specify where the block should be placed by providing coordinates as properties. And we can also decide what type of block we want by providing an ID. So let's try this out. Let's set the ID for the block to 1, which should correspond to stone. Nice, it's finally working. Let's try the 2, which should be grass. That's not grass. Okay, if it's not a block ID, what is it? Let's see what happens if we just loop over all of the IDs between 0 and 200. Okay, so we have some dirt, we have some stone, some samplings. But that's a lot of water blocks. Maybe it's not a block ID, maybe it's more of a state. Maybe it's a state ID.
Bruh.
But thanks to the Prismine block library, we do not actually have to look up every ID of every state for every block every time. The block component allows us to not only just specify the name of a block, but we can also specify the properties like orientation of a block. To see what states are available, I highly recommend minecraftitemids.com, which has a searchable list with all of the blocks that you could possibly need. Before we start building our very first house in Minecraft with React.js, there's one last thing that has to be implemented. To re-render the React Minecraft component, I registered a /reload command that can be executed via the Minecraft chat. Executing it will render new blocks correctly, but old blocks that are placed inside of our build are not cleared correctly yet, which is why we have to define an area where we want our React Minecraft build to be. This allows React Minecraft to reset the state of the blocks correctly. To do that, we can use the canvas component. It has a position inside of our Minecraft world as well as a size, and it makes sure that every block inside of it gets reset correctly every time that the React Minecraft component re-renders. So let's get finally started with building our house. First, we'll create the floor, which is just a square of spruce blocks surrounded by grass blocks. Let's go into our world and reload the house component. Perfect. We can see that our spruce floor is there and there are no holes either, but it doesn't look like a house yet. Next, we build four pillars of stripped dark oak wood on the corners of our Minecraft house. Pillars are just React components that use the third and last important component of Minecraft React: container. Containers are a way of grouping components together. Components inside of a container are always positioned relative to the container component's root. This makes it much easier to move around components and blocks after the fact, by just changing the position of our container instead of manually moving every block. This nesting is achieved with React use context hooks, which allows to pass down, use, and nest properties, in our case, X, Y, and Z coordinates. But you don't really have to think about all of that, as the container components take care of that already. But let's get back to our house. Next up are the walls. So let's create a component for one of the side walls and wrap it into a container so that we can not only use it on the right wall, but also on the left side by just changing the X coordinate. For the back wall, we'll use pillars again, but we'll make sure that the ones in the center go up higher so that they will fit a roof. For the front wall, let's just close it up for now and have it offset one block to the inside, just to change it up a bit. Next, let's put in the door and a few stairs as well to give the build some depth. Looks like we're getting somewhere. Give it a window on the top floor and extend the front wall to a non-existing roof as well. It still looks a little blank, so let's add some fences on the front to give it some character. Before it starts raining, we should put a roof on top of it. So let's start with the outline of stone brick stairs. Looking good. And finally, let's fill them up with some nice spruce stairs. Just a few more touches and we're done. We can use a reusable flowerbed component for the flowers next to the door, and break our entire house in the process while refactoring it. The amount of time that I broke something just because the coordinate system in Minecraft is, well, how it is actually insane. Instead of using X and Y as the axis for the floor, as it is used in math most of the time, Minecraft uses X and Z for the floor and Y for the height. And I was shocked to learn that it's not just Minecraft, it's the entire gaming industry. But then, they cannot even decide on what the X and the Z axis is. Why is this such a mess? Anyways, I swapped the coordinates and added two more long flower beds to the side of our house. And there it is. The first house ever built with React in Minecraft. If you want to try out building your own Minecraft house with React, head to the GitHub repository linked in the description down below, where you can find the house example as well as the general purpose components, canvas, container and block. Also, if you made it this far into the video, please consider leaving a like and subscribe to the channel as it helps me out a lot. If you have any ideas how to expand React Minecraft or want to help implement new features, feel free to open a ticket on the React Minecraft repository. I'm looking forward to seeing all of the things that people are gonna build with React Minecraft. Other than that, consider checking out this video where I made PHP work inside of Next.js. See you in the next one.